Our patient today is a 76-year-old male. He's been a dentureless for many, many years and has had multiple dentures made, but because of probably lack of muscle tone ability to secure his dentures, he's really unhappy with function. So we are going to use the BLX Pro Arch system to place the implants and immediately convert him to a immediate load maxillary mandibular hybrid prosthesis, provisionals. What's unique about him is that he has a bimax protrusion of his edentulous alveolar bone with a much narrower premaxillary bone as compared to the posterior bone. So we're going to use the BLX system because it has a single uniform prosthetic platform. So we plan on 4.5 millimeters in the posterior, 3.75 in the anterior maxilla, and by doing so, even though the surgical diameter of the implant is different, the prosthetic screw retained abutments will be the same. So for the restorative colleague, it's the same platform to be working on, one single platform. So it's a unique case that he has, once again, a bimax protrusion, so we're going to have to utilize the third degree abutments in the anterior maxilla that we usually don't. On the lower jaw, again, a very robust vertical mandibular height, but narrow width. So once again, we have as a backup in our algorithm, 4.5 millimeter BLXs to use, and if there's any reason why we should be going to a thinner diameter, our backup is 3.75. So we are immediately post-op, and we are quite pleased with our post-operative ICAT radiographs. We were able to place four maxillary BLX implants and four mandibular BLX implants following the Pro Arch protocol. Well, our implants were all over 40 newton centimeters of insertion torque, so we're very, very happy with our stability. And that's why we went ahead and used temporary titanium cylinders to convert the patient's denture to fixed provisionals. So now the patient has fixed maxillary mandibular provisionals. They are told and they are teased actually that they could actually eat a corn on a cob tonight. But once they start laughing, we tell them that you have to promise that you won't. So patient education is super important. They have to know that for the next 6 months, they have to eat soft diet. Anything they want to eat, as long as the consistency is not harder than well-cooked chicken or fish. And we explain this to them. It sounds a little bit silly, but we do. If you want to eat an apple, you bake it. This way patients understand that we really mean this, because we cannot abuse these implants. Now, on the mandible, we wait 3 months before we make the final prosthesis. On the maxilla, we wait 6 months. We wait for the bone to heal in the first 3 months, and then bone to mature for the next 3 months in the maxilla. But in the mandible, we are okay with 3 months. But in this case, it's an upper and lower case, so we just wait 6 months, and we do our final ProArch fixed hybrid restorations at one time for the patient.